everyone, welcome to Tespa Technologies Private Limited. Myself Arvind Paliwal and I am here to explain the working of three-phase transformer. The transformer kit which we are using here is order code 69017. A transformer is a device that transfers electrical energy from one circuit to another through inductively coupled conductors. The transformer coils a varying current in the first or primary winding, create a varying magnetic field in the transformer's core and thus a varying magnetic field through the secondary winding. This varying magnetic field induces a varying electromotive force EMF or voltage in the secondary winding. In an ideal transformer, the induced voltage in the secondary winding VS is in proportion to the primary voltage VP and is given by the ratio of number of turns on the secondary NS to the number of turns in the primary NP. A three-phase transformer is a combination of three no single phase transformers. Large scales of generation of electric power is usually three-phase at generated voltage of 11 kV and above. Three-phase transformers are necessary to step down this generated value of voltage at transmission and at distribution stage. A basic three-phase transformer consists of three sets of primary winding, one for each phase, and three set of secondary winding wound on the same iron core. Separated single-phase transformers can be used and externally interconnected to yield the same result as a three-phase unit. Basic principles. Transformer is based on two principles. First, that an electric current can produce a magnetic field, and second, that a changing magnetic field within a coil of wire induces a voltage across the ends of the coil. Changing the current in the primary coil changes the magnetic flux that is developed. The changing magnetic flux induces a voltage in secondary coil. Now, let's start with the procedure of connecting the circuits and getting out the voltages of output and input. Firstly, we will connect the first phase of primary side to the R terminal of the input, and then Y terminal to the Y terminal of input, and at last B terminal phase to the B terminal in the input. So now, as it is a star connected supply, we will short B terminal with Y terminal and the second terminal of R terminal with Y terminal. So now, as it start to star connection, so we will short the second terminal of B primary secondary supply to the second terminal of Y and the second terminal of Y to the second terminal of R in the secondary side. Now let's use a digital multimeter and calculate the voltage in the input side between line and neutral for B. It's near 230 volts. Line to neutral voltages in all the three phases will be same in the input side. You can verify it from this. In Y line, we also get 230 to 240 volt voltage, and in R side to neutral, we also get the same voltage. So for now, line to line voltage in the input side between R and Y is 420 volts. Between Y and R is also 420 volts. So the input supply of this transformer is from line to line is 420 volts, and from line to neutral is 230 volts. Now let's calculate the output voltage on the secondary side between line and neutral of first B. It's near 120 volts. Between Y and neutral, it's too near 120 volts. Between R and neutral, it's too near 120 volts. So now let's see the output voltage between two lines on the secondary winding. For B and Y, we get 220 volts. For Y and R, we get 220 volts. And similarly for R and B, we also get 220 volts. So the output of the output side on the secondary winding between two lines is 220 volts, and between line and neutral is 120 volts. The maximum output you can get from this transformer is 3000 VA. So here we are using a 3 kVA transformer. We have 1 kVA, 2 kVA and 5 kVA 2 respectively. So now we conclude this experiment, and if you like, please like, subscribe and share.